Lorraine was gonna bring the treasury ballot, so we don't have that. Do you wanna keep this? Or do you want me to keep it?
I don't care. You can keep it if you want, or you know anybody?
You'll do better with that than I will. So I don't know what the treasury is. Whatever it was last month, it is $100 richer. So that's what we'll have for a balance.
Minus 41 for the brochures.
Oh, okay. Did they pay for it? Oh, okay. So, that's not right. $41. Okay. Old business. Do we have any updates on the electricity or water? Still at a standstill?
I'll see if I can get hold of Bernie this week and, for the water. And, Holly, I talked to Holly. Supposedly she knows the electrician down here on Goose Pond Road. Done work for them and whatnot.
She sent me a memo and she would like to be here tonight, but doesn't think she'll make it because she has a doctor's appointment and, it's important, so. But she'll, you know, eventually pick up and catch up.
I'll send her an email and just ask her, you know, if she's heard from the electrician.
Yeah, good. Do you have her email?
Yeah.
Her new one?
Got a new one? Well, it.
The new one is Holly Mooney at. And I think it's all small letters. That's the way I copied it anyway. At SU57. I think this is, the nurses go to the schools and do certain tests, and I think she.
School Unit 57.
Yeah, SU57, yeah, .org. So that's Holly's new email. Okay. So we'll leave that be. You'll check into that. I will report on the cleanup day. And many, many accolades to you. You did a beautiful job on that sign.
Thank you.
Beautiful, very nice.
Good. It does show up better.
It does, yeah. And then the, you did a lot of raking before we got there. I was late there, on Friday, but we had a few people showed up. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 people that, you know, came and worked, and we got a considerable amount done. I didn't do all that much because I had to go early to something else. But anyways, it worked out good. It needs more work, I think. And Scott Mooney has agreed to bring in some materials to make the walkway to the privy easier to get in, and also to get some soil to fill in the spot under the pine trees down back. So that'll be, you know, good to use, hopefully. Okay, so that takes care of the sign and all of the cleanup.
A friend of mine had a picnic there 2 weeks ago with somebody, a friend of hers, who commented on the outhouse saying whoever built it did a beautiful job. So just to pass that along.
That place has come a long, long way from its original looks. Frank was there for the original. Have you met Frank before?
Not officially, but
oh,
we
Frank
met
Fairock, and this is Jean Achilles. And she's on a few boards in town now and pretty active.
Yeah, a little too much.
Well, so that takes care of that. Now, I've done a little bit of research trying to find someone to do the concert in the park, and I'd like to update on that right now because there are other things that need to be talked about, but this is the biggest one we've got going. I finally ended up meeting a man by the name of Bob Dearborn, And I reached that name from Holly Mooney to a woman at the school who sent me to Mr. Parsons at the Music Mill, who invited me to the Liberty Church, where they have music every other Saturday. And that particular Saturday, I talked to him. He invited me then, introduced me to a man that had called me afterwards and said that he has a lot of dates open and he can get a group to play, won't cost anything. And from what I understand, we can't charge. Because this is a, you'll have to explain that part, Dad.
I got thinking about that. I'm not really sure, but anyway. Somebody questioned whether we could, for a use of the town thing, whether we could charge. And so it was suggested that we could have a suggested donation.
Okay.
And we'll have a big bucket.
Even though it's considered a fundraiser, you right. can't charge.
Right. Well, when I mentioned this to one of the selectmen, he said, well, why can't you charge? So they weren't aware that that's a necessity. But I thought it would be nice if we charged, because then you'd have some idea how many people were coming. You know, this way, you won't know.
Yeah, we'll look into it some more.
Well, it'll get too late to, you know, get tickets and all that kind of stuff.
Before, when are you going to get, when do you want to?
Well, these are the dates.
We have it.
He said that, and I'm not absolutely positive on this, 9 o'clock at night is the middle of, you know, bedtime.
Yeah.
I'm half gone. And he called at 9 o'clock at night, and I'm talking about, who's this? Anyway, I think he said he was available on 8-9. That's August. But we have our picnic in the park in
the
August.
The following
and we don't
week,
want it.
Isn't it?
Yeah. So we can have 9-6 or 9-20. The other days, they're playing at Thomaston Fair and some other fairs.
When is Labor Day?
That's the first, I think. Let's see.
Yes,
it is the first.
6 might be good. Yeah.
I was thinking that too, but
I hate to go too late.
Right, in the weather. Right.
I mean, it could be good by the 20th, but you're taking a chance.
Right. Well, the thing that I would like to do, if we firm this up and we get a date, is to book Town Hall in case the weather is bad. We can come over here, but if we don't have a book here and
right.
they rent it out to somebody else, we won't
right.
get in. So is
back
the 6th agreeable here?
The 6th of September?
Yep. Yes. Sound good?
Yeah.
With this global warming, we'll probably have snow by then.
Oh, please. If we don't get some in the next week or two.
Bite your tongue.
So, okay, that'll be the concert. And I think 6:30 is a good time to start. That's the time they used down at the Liberty Church, and they're out by 10.
Oh, we would be up before that.
Out before then?
Oh, yeah.
If they start at 6:30, well, these concerts, you know, they have to go on a little bit. And what he did tell me is they play, they have from 5 to 7 players in the group. And they play a variety of bluegrass, country, and a little Irish tossed in.
Sounds great.
Yeah. So we'll see. And I put in here how many tickets, but we can't do that, and what price, we can't do that. But I was in charge of another function up at the church, and I got some men to come in to play, you know, this particular time. And when they got there, the man that was in charge said, well, you know, we charge for this. I said, what? We didn't have money to do anything with. I said, well, I said, how about if we pass the hat? He said, that'll do. So when they get all through, I think they had more money than if they had charged the people to come.
Wow.
So this could work out the same way.
Yeah. I was kind of wondering, you know. Same thing, you know, that if you ask for donation, maybe somebody would give a little bit more.
Yeah, right. Well, The interesting thing is, they had, the way it was set up, the hall was long this way, and the band was set up over that way, and there was like posts, lally columns, and in two places wound around were donation boxes. And people constantly going up and putting money in, so it seems to work out all right down there.
We could put buckets, like in the four corners.
We'll have to have sentries, though.
Yeah, well, that's easy. That would be good. Seats, we just advertise it. Bring your lawn chairs or blankets.
Yeah, you have to bring your lawn chair or blanket, because we really don't have enough chairs. And that brings another article. I would like, Dick's going to mention it. And anybody, if you know anybody's getting rid of their lawn chairs,
we'll take them up to the transfer station.
You did? Yeah. If they bring them, because what we have over there now is from the top. But they're working out okay. They're working out. So the next thing, we're all settled on that, is the art in the park. That's the in July. Now let's see, where do I have it? July 26th. And there's a lot of interest in that. And every time I talk to someone, oh wow, I can this or I can that. So there's a man, a young man, who's doing iron turning, you know, making, I don't know what you call it.
Wrought iron?
Wrought iron, something. He turns it and makes designs out of it. Mm-hmm. And he would like a spot, but it's an iffy, I'm not sure.
So will this be kind of like a craft fair? With people bringing,
it'll be an all kinds of fair. My son-in-law is going to bring. He makes tie-dye, you know, shirts, and he will be there. There's a couple of people. Dick Johnson said he will be there. He's going to do watercolors.
No.
Two people are coming that do make jewelry. And
so this isn't going to be a hands-on.
Yeah.
Do the art. Yeah. Oh, it is.
They will be making the stuff.
Oh, they will be doing it.
Hopefully, that's what I'm
right
trying
there.
To explain
okay.
to everybody.
Okay.
That, but then again, some
so like a demonstration.
But some people will just display whatever okay. it is they're doing and maybe talk about it. I don't know how we can handle it other than say, do your own thing. And suggests that they bring their table. And I was talking to some, I get my toes done on Tuesday morning, and every time I go someplace, I get somebody to talk to. And this particular man was talking about a man that does artwork. Oh, I know how we got it. Mel's Diner, restaurant down in Springvale just opened.
Yeah.
And have you been there?
Not yet.
There's painting on the walls that are beautiful. And I was saying this, and the man that was there said, oh, I know who painted that. He does wonderful artwork. And I said, just the man I want to talk to. So I talked about Art in the Park, and he wanted my name and telephone number. And I said, well, the only thing is he has to know to bring his own seat and his own table. And he said, well, if he doesn't have one, I'll get him one. So, you know, everybody is addressing this positively. And
so maybe that should be advertised on the
yes on the cable. I want to get these things on the cable. And but the other thing is, I want to get, especially for Art in the Park, is to formulate a flyer someplace. I have it here. This is what I've got so far, and then I just wrote on my ideas. Do you have a special talent to share or put on supply for others to enjoy? If you do and would like a table, please call. And I've used my telephone number, but I could use Lorraine's office phone number if I needed to.
Both.
And then I could put a photography, jewelry design and creation, ironworks, tie dyes. I don't know if that's right.
No.
Is it TIE? You never know. Everything's so different with toll work. I don't have anyone doing toll work.
What is toll work?
Toll is when they paint on the metal.
Uh-huh.
That's called toll work. Usually, like Pennsylvania did Dutch design, that type of thing, goes on the, you see trays or something, well anyways, that, and I put watercolors because Dick Johnson said that, and then any kind of paintings, and if you can think of anything else or anybody else that
friend
wants
of mine to does needle felting, she might be interested.
Needle felting?
They make all kinds of little things, animals, stuff out of wool, and it's a big thing now, needle felting.
Wow.
And you know, Robin Cobb from Shopley does painting on feathers. She might be interested. Will these people be selling as well
if
as
they,
demonstrating?
If they, you know, if they somebody wants to buy their wares and they are selling it, sure, why not?
Okay.
And what I'm going to do is suggest that maybe we put a donation jar out there. So anyone that comes to show the wares.
Whenever we have.
We put the donation jar.
Yes. Yeah,
I agree.
And I also thought, since we're not going to be charging for tables, I've set the time for this at 11. I know you said noon, but I'm suggesting 11, because if you go from 11 to 3, by the time they get in and set up, and if it was at 12 o'clock, that doesn't leave much time to, you know, they got to set up and all this and that. So I'm thinking if we do it at 11, then maybe we could do some, maybe hamburgers and hot dogs and cold drinks, and that's how we could make some money.
Yeah, good.
And I hate it that the camera's on. We were down to Lowe's yesterday and set up, we go into the contractor's place, was a table, not a table, but a like a cooking grill, about this long and at least that wide. And Bob said, gee, I'd like to get one of them. I said, good, get one. And I said, the Mary Graham people will borrow it. And well, what they were doing, it's a promotional thing, but the girl was frying sausages and eggs, and they came out fabulous on this great big grill. And I thought, wow, that sounds good. So if he gets it, we'll borrow it. And do so sandwiches are dogs, and we'll figure out later how to do this,
good.
And burgers. I'll find one of my kids will.
I don't. Do they still have a hot dog steamer in the kitchen?
I don't know. I didn't know they ever had one. Who had that?
But we need electricity.
I thought there was one in the kitchen.
Yeah. Do you think we'll have electricity by then?
Oh, that's right. Yeah. I hope so.
Well, yeah. What do you think?
We'll check it out.
Yeah. If we do,
but if
you can use it if we have it, mm-hmm. And if not, you put them on the grill.
Yeah. Right. But the first time that we needed electricity, was that for the event that we had when Helen Wentworth came? And the man across the street, Mr. Crum is his name, let us use his electricity. We dragged the thing across the street.
All the way across.
Hey? We'll invite him. We'll tell him he could have a free ticket to the concert. Okay, so we'll do that for the La Park. Does anybody want to do signs?
What kind of signs do you want?
To tell you the truth, my computer is... It works when it feels like working. And I used to be able to do, you know, bigger letters, and now I can't do anything on it. I have to fight with the silly thing. And I don't want to spend any money.
Mine will do anything on this size paper. Is that what you want?
Does it have to be paper, or can you do it on
I can do it heavier? On cardstock.
Yeah, yeah. On different colors, maybe, so for whatever we have.
But the thing is, if it's going to be outside, you know, it runs if it gets wet.
Right. Well, basically, we will be putting these, like, one in Town Hall, one
and
up at the church.
And you can put them in sleeves.
Yeah.
That's what I do for the bulletin board at the lake.
Well, that will be the general idea. And in here, you'll also put in Lorraine's. Whatever the town number is, plus her extension.
Okay.
and they can call her.
Well, email me her, the number and extension.
If my email will work. I was trying to send an email to Holly because she...
Call me then.
Okay, that's what I'll do. Yeah. Do I have your phone number?
No, you've got my email.
Okay. 63?
477.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Marion's over there with that number.
0310.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll do that. I wish Lorraine was here because we can't really talk about Picnic in the Park because she was going to say whether or not she got Wes Ham. She was going to see if we could...
Okay. You want me to call him?
Wes Ham?
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be good. Then we won't have to worry about what's going to happen.
Is he on the committee?
No.
No.
No, but, yeah, that's right. You weren't here for the last meeting. Lorraine said that, you know, last year there was a man out of Sanford that came up and gave, did you go to the Picnic in the Park last year? His name was Raymond Payer, and he came and did...
I know Raymond.
Yeah. Okay, well, he came last year and talked about all kinds of things. And he was very good, and I found him by accident because I've got a big mouth.
I talked about mast, the ship's mast.
Yeah.
He's done some work on that.
He's done a lot of work. Well, anyways.
He also probably talked about that Japanese submarine aircraft carrier.
Right. And you know, he was on television being interviewed by somebody. I was someplace in the house, and Bob's yelling, come in here, come in here. He said, isn't this the man that was talking at the park? And it was him, giving a, you know, to 60 Minutes or something, whatever. Well, anyways, we were trying to figure out what would we do this year for Picnic in the Park. And Lorraine is the one that suggested him, so we'll see what'll happen there. But we still have another meeting. You know, we've got June meeting and to pull these things together. And let's see, and then we've got the concert. That's, let's see, July, August, the concert in September. And then the following thing will be the pumpkin carving in October. And that takes care of itself, basically. We just get the Mr., I can't think of his name now.
Kelly.
Gave the pumpkins last year.
That's good.
And he did the year before, too. So.
Well, you've done a lot. A friend of mine had offered to do a drumming circle because it seemed uncertain whether you'd find a band. So maybe we don't need another fundraiser. But
what was
a drumming circle. A drumming circle is where people come together with drums. And she facilitates drumming, and she has lots of drums, so to let people use. And it would be a nice family activity that kids and adults and all could drum. So I don't know if that's something we want to kind of hold.
Is there a charge for that, or does she come in?
I think she would do it just to help out, because... She comes, she loves our park.
Well, if she would do it, would like to, she could do it for the,
True.
July 26th. I hate this being on tape.
All right, I'll check with her and see if she'd be free and able to do it.
That would be nice. You can put any, I just wrote all
Can I throw your pen?
I should mention also that Dick has gone and got us these new brochures to advertise Mary Grant. Nice job. Tells all the whole story and how it got started.
I never realized that Mary Grant never married, huh?
No.
I thought Dr. Grant was her
Thank
husband.
You.
No, that his wife's name was Rebecca?
No.
Was Rachel?
I forget.
Who was it now?
No.
Well, anyways, she was the daughter. And an awful lot of the things we found in the old house referenced Mary. He absolutely idolized her. And then Dick had some little slide pictures he picked up. They're practically all of them are of Mary and something that he did with her. So, yeah.
This is a very nice day.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
I think we should hang one up in the out here.
When I submitted my bill, I gave them three or four or five.
Good.
You know, for the selectmen to see what.
Good, yeah. Well, to lay on the desk where people come in, you know. Even if you had a little, you know how you see in the banks or something, little stands with them in?
We probably should have some in the library and in Lorraine's office.
Good, yeah.
Or Jennifer's office.
Right. So what do you think?
I think it's great. I think
we have a nice program going.
Yeah.
And my intentions right now is to, you know, have a rip-roaring season here and then have somebody take over next year. Right? Frank wants to take over next year?
It'd be hard to match your energy.
Oh, no. You know, this was...
We're going to get some young blood.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
I'm trying to do that for the lake, yeah.
I know it. But the young people seem to have their heads on for other things. I don't know what it is.
Be politically correct.
Oh. No. Okay.
Don't want anybody...
So we're all set. We have our dates.
Beautiful. You've done a lot of work.
And we'll see if we get the rest of the committee together. Last time I sent out emails. Remember, we have the meeting? And I thought, now they know we're going to meet next month on Tuesday. I'll have to send out emails. Yeah.